A lot of people laugh, but to me, there's nothing funny about it.
The fabled L.A. punk scene of a decade ago churned up such bands as Black Flag, The Germs, The Circle Jerks, and Social Distortion. Some of these groups were ravaged by drugs and degeneration, but Social Distortion, at least, has managed to survive.
I used to put all this energy into fighting and copping drugs and getting money and all this, doing burglaries and all this. All this energy was going towards that, and now that that's not a part of my life anymore, I can direct the energy towards what it's, I think, what it was supposed to be for, and that's the music.
By whatever I have done, I'm ashamed to find myself in.
Social Distortion's new major label debut album demonstrates that the band survived the LA punk scene because it was able to grow beyond the standard three-chord thrash. Now shades of Chicago blues, rockabilly, and even country crop up in the group's music, as in the current single, Ball and Chain.
Take away.
Not just my story, it could be anybody's, and it could have happened 10 years ago or 10 years from now, but it's a traditional country song, I think.
Speaking of offbeat songs, the album also finds these LA punk pioneers covering, of all things, Johnny Cash's classic Ring of Fire.
I love the song, and other bands have done it, but it's like we wanted to do it with Marshalls, you know, machine gun guitars, and it's a love song. It's an outlaw love song, and that's kind of the image that we got.
Now that they've survived the drugs, crime, and musical limitations that scuttled so many of their fellow LA punks, Social Distortion does not plan to blow it or to stand still.
We really got a good bond. We stuck through the hard times and continue to grow together and see a little bit of success together along with the hard times, and it's neat.